we want a very simplified version of the Dutchman, like this is the story of a young woman, Senta, who is so obsessed with the picture and is looking at it so intensely that she will eventually be swallowed by it and actually transfer herself into that world. So it is based on the belief of what a tableau or an image could do, and this is what Senta is experiencing. She is drawn into the portrait of the Dutchman. One of the difficult aspects of dealing with the Dutchman is the ghost factor. Probably the first thing we needed to resolve is that problem. How do you signify the supernatural nature of the Dutchman on stage? We are basically creating a virtual shadow of the Dutchman. When the Dutchman walks on stage, he will carry with him a live generated shadow, and that shadow will be triggered by a dancer off stage who will mimic every gesture of the singer. The journey of the Dutchman has some kind of a spiritual resonance in our production. One big inspiration was a diary of Wagner, what he wrote on his way to Paris from Riga. He had to stop in Norway, take refuge, protect himself from a huge storm. And we went in to research these villages where he actually had the seed idea for the Dutchman and where he lived that storm. And it's a rocky land and the fjords of Norway and also the villages and the fishermen. So we actually centered our staging, and that includes sets, rocks, costumes, sailors, fishermen, and used that as the seed inspiration for all elements. Our mission is to capture the essence of a piece and try to make it resonate for an audience. In here, completely, I think it's the obsession of a ghost, a portrait, another world, the other world, the au-delà, we say in French. And I think if we, my aim is to try to capture that and engrave that in anyone's memory.